Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see shortly and easily all you need to know to start designing 3D projects with Autodesk AutoCAD 2018. Leave us comments in the video description to improve our next video guides for AutoCAD. In the previous video of this guide, we have seen how to design and draw 2D objects by using all the tools inside the Draw section under the Home tab. All these 2D objects always lay on the ground plane defined by the X and Y axis and checked from top to bottom through a top view on the 3D view cube. In case of a 3D project, you have to work in a 3D perspective view where both the ground plane and the height from it are shown. You can switch to a 3D view by clicking on a vertex or a side of the 3D view cube. At this point, you won't have just the X red axis for the horizontal direction and the Y green axis for the vertical direction, as you can see from the gizmo system. You will also have the Z axis in blue color, indicating the height from the ground. At this point, rectangles, circles, arcs, and polylines always lay on the ground plane with no height. Indeed, the line objects and the 3D polyline are the only 2D objects that are able to spread over the Z axis. The 3D polyline works just like polylines, with the difference being that you can't draw any curved side. Inside a 3D view, the majority of the 2D modify tools still work, such as the rotate and the mirror tools, but always with respect to all that lays on the ground plane. Indeed, 2D drawing and editing tools always follow the XY ground plane. This means that if you rotate the gizmo system with respect to the X or the Y axis, you will be able to draw and edit 2D objects by following a different ground plane. Keep in mind that when you rotate the gizmo, also the 3D view cube will be rotated with respect to the cardinal circle. By using the 2D drawing tools and rotating the gizmo system, you can draw 3D objects, but this may be complex and time-consuming. For this reason, AutoCAD provides several 3D drawing tools in order to create and drop regular 3D objects in just seconds. By default, these 3D tools are hidden, so just right-click on a vacant space on top and go to 3D Tools under Show Tabs. This tab lists all the main commands and tools to build and edit 3D objects. For example, you can draw a simple box by enabling the Box tool and fixing 3 points on your workspace. While you draw, it is very important to preview your 3D project in the correct way. On the far right, you have the main visualization tools, such as the 3D view cube and the navigation bar. You can click on the vertices, the edges, and the faces of the 3D view cube to check any 3D point of view, including main perspectives like top, front, left, right, and so on. To apply free 3D rotation instead, you can enable the orbit command from the navigation bar and click and drag on your workspace. Use the escape key to exit. It is also important to choose the correct view for your 3D projects. All these views are listed right below the project tabs. The default one is called 2D Wireframe, and this is properly used for 2D basic projects due to its simple and essential representation. However, this may not be suitable for 3D objects, since this view does not show any volume or any object gizmo that we will see later. If you click on 2D Wireframe, you can open and choose another view, for example, Realistic for a quick and simple 3D render, or X-ray in order to check both volume and the main 3D object's points, such as vertices and sides. Consider that all these 3D views do not affect 2D objects at all, since these do not have any volume. Let's now see the main tools to draw your 3D objects. All of these are collected inside the Modeling section under 3D Tools. The first tool from the left lists 3D drawing tools used to draw the main regular objects, such as cubes, pyramids, and cones. When drawing boxes, cylinders, cones, and pyramids, you have to fix two points first to create their base, and then a third point to define the object height. Keep in mind that the 3D object base always lays on the XY ground plane or any plane parallel to it, as seen for 2D objects. The object height follows the direction of the Z-axis, so if you rotate the main gizmo, the 3D object will lay on the inclined ground plane. Other objects, such as spheres and tori, do not have an object base, so these are drawn by fixing two or three points on your workspace in order to define radius and placement. Also, these objects lay on the ground plane exactly at their half. The other four tools listed are used to build 3D objects starting from 2D shapes and polylines. Let's check them. The extrude tool creates 3D objects by extruding a 2D base through the Z axis. Select the 2D object to extrude, apply with the Enter key, and define the extrusion height. When you fix the height, the 3D object is created. This tool also works on 2D objects inclined with respect to the ground plane. The Resolve tool creates a 3D object by rotating a 2D object around a defined axis. Select the 2D object to use as section, apply with the Enter key, and then fix two points to define the axis direction. Then, just check the preview to define how to resolve the object. Make sure that the axis does not intersect the 2D shape to revolve, or the tool won't work. The Loft tool is used to create a 3D object with a variable section. Select, in order, all the 2D objects to be used as sections, checking the preview. Then use the Enter key twice to apply. Make sure to have all the 2D sections aligned, or the tool fails. Then there is the Sweep tool, used to create a 3D conductor with a constant section taken by a 2D object and with a direction given by a 2D polyline path. Select first the object to take as section and then the path to follow. When the conductor is created, both the 2D shape and path will disappear. Besides the tools inside the modeling section, you have other tools to create customized shapes, like the Mesh or the PolySolid tool. The Mesh tool is used to create complex and irregular shapes, starting from a regular one. To learn more about it, check out the next video in this guide. The Poly tool is perfect to create 3D walls in no time. As seen for 2D polylines, the PolySolid is a simple series of consecutive boxes with fixed height and width, which can be either straight or curved. Enable the tool and use either the command line or the dialog box to fix the height and the width for each block. Type the value, apply with the Enter key, and drop boxes by fixing points on your workspace. By default, the blocks are straight, but you can draw curved walls by choosing Arc and draw straight boxes again by choosing Line. Use Close to close the shape. Remember that also the PolySolid base lays on the ground plane with its height on the Z-axis, as seen for the other 3D objects. Now, let's see everything you need to know to edit 3D drawings. In order to edit correctly, it is better to use a 3D view that shows the object's skeleton, such as the wireframe or the X-ray view. When using these, you still find the same identical blue nodes on the selected 2D objects in order to move and stretch them as seen in the previous video guide. When selecting a 3D object, you will get several nodes on the object base. Use the central one to move fast, use the vertex nodes to stretch the base shape, and use the blue arrows to size the extrusion depth or any radius. You can edit the PolySolid in the same way by acting on its base in order to stretch vertices or regulate any arc radius. Also, you can edit the first block to size height, width, and inclination over the whole PolySolid. When using a 3D view, a gizmo system appears on the selected object with all the main three axes. This is very useful to make quick and simple editing on the object. By default, the gizmo system is used to move the selected object. If you click and drag from an axis, you will move the object according to its direction only. Or you can move with respect to an overall plane by clicking and dragging from a gizmo plane. Furthermore, if you go to Gizmo under Selection, you can choose other gizmo systems. For example, the one to scale the object precisely, or to rotate it with respect to the three axes. Also, if you have multiple objects selected, the gizmo system will affect all of these. Let's now see how to edit the shape of your 3D objects. You can apply almost all the 2D tools inside the Modify section, also on 3D objects, but consider that these act on the object base only. But you can find advanced editing tools inside the Solid Editing section under 3D Tools. Press Pull is used to regulate the extrusion depth of 3D faces. Select the proper face boundaries, apply with the Enter key, and then regulate its depth. Use the Escape key to finish with the tool. Use Slice to split a 3D object with a 2D plane. Select an object, apply with the Enter key, and then fix two points to define the second plane that will slice the object. Then, click on the object side you want to keep, or choose Keep Both Sides in the dialog box to keep both. Fillet and Camper Edge are used to shape the object edges. If you use Fillet Edge, select the 3D edges and apply with the Enter key. Then you can find the fillet by choosing Radius or using the blue arrow you see on the edges affected. The Camper Edge tool works the same, with the difference that here you do not set a unique radius, but you regulate the distances from the original edge. Other tools inside Solid Editing work with multiple objects that get overlapped. Use Union to unify several objects together in order to obtain a unique object. Use Subtract to remove the overlap volume from the first object selected. Enable the tool and select the first object. Apply with the Enter key and then select all the objects to subtract from the first one selected previously. Use Interfere to check the overlap volume between the first and second selected object. This will be highlighted in red color with a dialog box that allows to check it better. Uncheck the Delete option below if you want to extract the overlap volume without affecting the original overlapping objects. Use Intersect to extract the overlap volume from the selected objects, deleting both of them in the end. This is all you need to know to start drawing 3D objects inside AutoCAD. Have a look at the next video in this guide to start using 3D surfaces and mesh objects inside AutoCAD 2018.